So guys, I want you to go crazy. I want you to go wild. I want you to take the roof off for your next act, the very fabulously brilliant Mr. Rick Edwards!
Thanks for coming along. You were sort of having a nice afternoon?
Yes.
It might be about to change a bit, I think. I've been sent a load of jokes by our viewers, and I'm just going to sort of read them out and see if you like them. I've got loads of them. I've got like 700, and the quality is variable. It's variable. So I guess it's just a question of don't shoot the messenger. Just because he's delivered a terrible pun. But equally, do laugh at the messenger if he delivers it well. Or chances on a funny ad-lib, which would be chance. For ease of consumption, for you guys, I've divided it into manageable chunks, sort of themed chunks. I don't know how much we'll get through, it's just sort of suck it and see, really. So I'll just rattle through, and if you want to laugh at any point, feel free. You're very welcome. If you have a question, equally, just ask. And then I'll, if you want it, likewise, heckling, if you think I'm a lanky freak, just shout it out, or rubbish, or both, just shout those, and I'll just get on with it, really, I'll sort of ignore it. So the first section, if by any miracle you sent one of these jokes in, let us know, and then we can sort of laud you, or pillory you, more likely. So first section, and this is in the broad theme of animals, so it's sort of your giraffes, that sort of thing. No actual giraffe jokes, actually, but it's the animal kingdom. Right, what do you call a fish without an eye? Joe. That's a shame for Jo from Hansk. I think she thought she was an original. And I think that's better written down anyway. Why doesn't a seagull fly over the bay? Participate.
Why doesn't a seagull fly over the bay?
Thank you very much, madam. Because it would be called a bagel. I think being called a bagel would be all right. Sophie Redfern in Oxford says, I think animal testing's a terrible idea. They get all nervous and give the wrong answers. I like that because of just the image it conjures up of a load of mice with sort of ears, pig's ears grafted to their back sitting in exam. Just like a lower tier maths GCSE going, oh dear. Says this ear's not helping. Okay, I should prefix this, Jay. If you don't know, there's a thing called a horsefly. This is weaker even than if you do know. Have you ever seen a horsefly, which is a thing? No, but I once saw a cow jump off a cliff, incidentally. What do you get? This is my mum's favourite joke. Fact, although she didn't send it in, so it's obviously doing the rounds, like my mum. She doesn't do that. Imagine if she did. Although she's not. What do you do when you get when you sit under a cow? A pat on the head. And it's particularly interesting because my mum's name is Pat. I don't know if that's what she likes. But she's, to be fair, she's not a funny woman. This is no Peter Neasley. I don't know how you've made it into the binder. Okay, a man with a seagull on his head walks into the surgery. Presumably doctors, doesn't say. Let's see. Doctor, I've got a human stuck to my feet. Sort of just playing with you, you'd think it would be the human that would say something. There's two cows in a field, spelt wrong, I before E except after C. Come on, Ellie Newcastle. This is going out on television. Two cows in a field, one says moo, the other says I was just about to say that. Why couldn't the chicken fly through the window? It was closed. Two fish in it. This is in the wrong. I should have put this in the old joke section. I've made an error. I apologise. Two fish in a tank. One says to the other, how'd you drive this thing? Because the word for what they live in normally is the same as an armoured vehicle. What do you call a deer with no eyes? No idea. Should have been the old jokes again. What type of bees produce milk? Boobies. A little bit cheeky. A little bit cheeky.